evening and welcome to
Epilepsy
Today!
Yeah! Yes, spruce it up a little bit.
Why not? Margaux!
Yes! Tom!
Did you forget my name or what?
No, I thought you forgot mine.
There was a kind of pause there.
I was just trying to make a balance. It seemed like we were on this pause thing, so I was like, "All right, well, I'll take a step back, breathe, and then I'll think of your name."
Now,
yeah.
Okay.
So what we got on deck today?
What we have on deck is actually steroids and the diet. And you know, at first thought, you think, oh my gosh, what are they going to be talking about here today?
Well, bodybuilding. That's what makes
pump.
The
what were the two guys?
Oh, we like to pump you up. And then the double check. They came back for the double check commercial.
I forget their names, but they are, it's a hoot.
They're like the old school Saturday Night Live.
The two guys. Hans and...
I forget. Is it cons?
I don't know.
Anyway, not those steroids. That's not the steroids we're getting ready to talk about. This is for a recipe for success.
For success. Yes, exactly. And to give you a little background on this, okay? Sometimes young children who have seriously difficult seizures that are difficult to control will sometimes be placed on certain types of steroid medications in order to try to establish control over their seizures.
Okay.
So that's the type of steroids that we're talking about, not the kind that anabolic steroids that you use to bulk up and stuff.
I never thought I'd be good at that show, the bodybuilding shows. It just seems really intense. You ever seen them?
I have.
They're kind of scary. I mean, you know, I just don't ever want to meet those type of people on the street unless they're my friends. It just seems like they've got a lot of
what issues?
I won't say that, you know. You don't have to be a bodybuilder to have issues, for sure. But at any rate, so these aren't those. These are to help the children.
And the diet isn't what we usually think is a diet either.
No, it's not. What is it?
Okay. This is about the ketogenic diet. The ketogenic diet is a diet that is used to control epilepsy.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And what the diet does is the diet is based on an individual taking in a lot of fats and very few carbohydrates. Okay, so it's a high fat, low carbohydrate diet, and it's very precise. It's like they have ratios that you have to follow, and they give you a menu, and they say, okay, this is what you have to eat. So you might be eating bacon, you might be eating maybe whipping cream or something such as that.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really, really high in fats. Now the good thing about this is that this diet has a lot of success as far as controlling people's epilepsy.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so it works. It works especially for small kids because they can't control their diet. You know, they can't say, "Heck with this! I'm going to go to McDonald's and get a large order of fries,"
which are carbs, and that's something that you can't have doing this.
So the diet is the ketogenic diet, and what the diet does is basically it produces ketosis, which is where they get the name from.
Okay.
Ketosis is, and then what we know is that once the body is in a state of ketosis, which means that it's burning fat instead of carbs, it seems to create a protective effect as far as seizures are concerned.
Interesting.
Yeah. So it works, but it's tough.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't stay on a diet for more than half a day.
On diet.
I'll see.
I don't know. And then that's when we were talking about the carbs. That's one of my favorite things. So that's really dedication too. I mean, I love pasta.
I love bread.
Oh goodness, I used to be a sad lady.
But okay, now the thing, what happened was they did a study. When they took folks who were on the ketogenic diet, and these are children, Okay, because it's primarily used with children.
Could adults do it though?
Yeah, an adult could do it.
Okay.
Okay, and it has, and it has very good success rates.
Okay.
Okay, but being on a diet is tough. You know.
Yeah. So it does. It's very. But they well did with treat. Yeah.
They did it with children who, 42 children who were treated with both a high dose of steroids and the ketogenic diet at the same time. They had infantile spasms or Landau-Kleffner syndrome, types of epilepsy, which basically steroids can help. The ketogenic was diet was started using a 4-to-1 ratio following 24 hours of fasting. So you got to fast for 24 hours. Mm. Can you imagine that? Mm. They'd have to probably put me in a, I hate to say it, cage or something, you know? Because...
That's a long time to have to, I mean.
Wouldn't it be funny?
Especially if that, because is that now, is that just, they had to do that once as they started it, or is that that 24-hour fasting period something that can to continue with the type, with this study?
Okay, that's to start the diet. They fast you for 24 and then they put you on this diet.
Okay.
You know, and then afterwards, you know, you're so hungry that you think, hey, this stuff isn't too bad.
Well, right. We really don't give you a choice.
Here, you want to eat? After 24 hours, you know, it's like, if it is dead, I'll eat it, you know? So that's basically what happens. I hate to say that. This is bad. But 14 responded to the diet and all maintained moderate to large ketosis. These 14 children were able to successfully come off steroids, which was part of the goal of trying the ketogenic diet in the first place. No child had infections that are both bad for the diet and the ketogenic diet. Mm-hmm. Okay, in summary, being on standing long-term oral steroids does not appear to be a reason to avoid the ketogenic diet. This is important for children with infantile spasms and also with Landau-Kleffner syndrome on steroids looking for another option for seizure control. The thing of it is that sometimes, you know, taking steroids for a long period of time is not good.
Right.
You know, it's not good for your body and can cause all kinds of problems in the cell. So you can, in fact, make that transition from those oral steroids to the ketogenic diet.
And basically, is that what is predominantly trying to start maybe that stair step to just getting into the ketogenic diet instead of being so
dependent on the steroids?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And I think that's where they're trying to go with this. It's just another option. And I think overall, you know, the ketogenic diet is a much healthier option for the child, because some of these kids can be really, really young.
That, and then you think about, I mean, just being on already your seizure medication on top of the steroid or trying to figure out all of that, that's just another mixture of mayhem, too, so.
Oh, you're absolutely right. You know, so, and a lot of times with the ketogenic diet, we get them off of all those medications. They're just on the diet.
And that's great.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the way to go.
If possible.
Right.
If possible. That's certainly a lot better than having a very young child who's on super high doses of anti-epileptics. Mm-hmm. Okay, so good thing.
So now, if you're interested in steroids, diets, or just more information about both that apply to children and ketogenic diets and help with that, please feel free to visit the Epilepsy Foundation webpage.
Which is
www.epilepsy-ohio.org. Yes, I got the easy pieces too. Yeah. Or you can call 513-721-2905.
Yeah. Or even go to epilepsy.com. You might be able to find some information. I'm sure you can find information there.
Yes.
You know? Or talk to the people at a children's hospital. Yeah. There are some hospitals that are more open to ketogenic diets than other hospitals. But it's become a proven remedy.
And that's
for
good.
Controlling seizures.
So just seek more information. If you've had questions and if you're trying to find a different option for your child, or if you want to be headstrong and try to do a new diet, this is the way to go.
Okay.